Welcome to another 2-minute update. Today we're focusing on a federal contractor's and subcontractor's duty to survey its workforce for disability information. In 2014, regulations implementing Section 503 of the Rehabilitation Act were updated to require federal contractors to invite their employees to voluntarily self-identify as an individual with a disability. These updates further require contractors to resurvey their workforce for disability status at least once every 5 years and issue a reminder between the 5-year interval. For most contractors, this requirement became effective with their 2015 affirmative action plan. Therefore, with the start of the 2020 calendar year, now may be the time for you to resurvey if you haven't done so already. Now, why the requirement to resurvey? Well, the reason is that disability is not necessarily a lifelong condition. For example, an employee can become disabled while employed, recover from a previous disability, or someone with an existing disability may feel more comfortable self-identifying only once they've been employed for some time.
It's important to remember contractors are required to use the voluntary self-ID form prepared by the OFCCP, which must be separate from other employee disclosure forms. This form can be found on the OFCCP's website and is offered in English, Spanish, and several other languages. It's an OMB-approved form, and its content cannot be altered or changed. OFCCP proposed revisions to the form last fall. The revised form is consolidated onto one page and removes the accommodation notice. The revised form also includes some potentially misleading language about employers' obligations to hire individuals with disabilities and assurances about who within the employer's organization will have access to the information provided. Until the OMB approves the proposed changes, contractors should continue to use the current form. We'll keep you updated on further developments.